In this problem, we've been asked to build a simplified Sudoku checker. In this version, we're given an n by n matrix, in this case n equals 3, and we're going to ensure that every number appears once in every column and once in every row. So in this example, the 1 appears once in this column, once in this column, once in this column, once in this row, once in this row, and once in this row. And we can repeat that check for every digit in the grid. Here's our plan of action for solving this problem. We're going to go through each digit, 1 through n. In this case, 1 through 3. So we're going to start with 1, and we're going to go through each row and column at the same time, checking to see that that digit occurs once and only once in each row and column. So here we see 1 appears once in the first row and the first column. So we increment our counts by 1. Then we check the second entry in the row and the column, and then the third entry. At the end of checking each entry in the row and the column, we check our count and ensure that it equals 1 for both. If either one is not equal to 1, then this grid is not correct. Otherwise, if we go through each digit and see that every digit appears once and only once in every row and column, then this grid satisfies our modified Sudoku property, and we return true. Let's code this up. So here's the finished code for this problem. First, we extract the size of the grid by looking simply at the length of the list P. Then we start with the first digit and go through each digit, checking each row and column at the same time. And for each entry in the row and the column, we see if that entry equals our digit. If it does, we increment our counts. Otherwise, we just move on to the next entry. Once we go through that row and the column, we ensure that the row count and the column count both are exactly 1. If they aren't, then we return false and stop, because the grid has already violated our Sudoku property. Otherwise, we keep going to the next row and the column until we've gone through each row and column for that digit. After we are done with that digit, we move on to the next digit. We go through every digit, ensuring the Sudoku property for each digit. We return true, because there was nothing wrong with the grid, so therefore, it passes the test.